We worked with Yale University, and we were really inspired by some of the research that they were doing on something called the four P's. And we integrated that approach into a model which we call Google Foods Easy Choice Model. And there are three components. The first part is, what is the product offering? Making sure the better choices are always available and are the easiest to access. And that leads us to the next principle, which is the choice architecture. It's really then where we lay these choices out in the line. And the final component of the model is communications. So we think a lot about the storytelling, getting that right message to our users at the right time.
We want to ensure that we're connecting with our users and offering things that they expect in a salad station. But what we also do to keep it interesting is we'll mix up the variety of ingredients to ensure that there's always something interesting for people to find that's new that may not have been there a couple of weeks ago. Studies have shown that the larger the vessel you serve product in, the more likely people are to take more food. So I'm putting out smaller vessels of food. One, you're preserving the quality and integrity of the food because it's coming out fresher in smaller components. And then the associated small wares that come with it make it easy to ensure that you're getting a right-sized portion. And the beautiful thing about a plated concept or a plated station is the chefs can really be very, very thoughtful on the entire composition of a dish. Unlike a buffet setting where it's almost a choose-your-own-adventure.
Looks delicious. Thank you very much.
What we have here are a variety of different salads that are personalizable based off of different dressings, and we're making it very easy for users to come in here, grab a salad, grab their choice of dressing, whether it's a creamy ranch or maybe the balsamic, and be on their way.
It's everywhere.
If you think about the priming that we heard and saw when we walked into the cafe, we think about the chef's passion when they delivered the dish to me with a smile, and that authenticity and the excitement. All of these elements, plus the delicious flavor that I'm going to enjoy and all the aroma that I can smell, all of these come together to ensure that truly we're making that better choice as easy as possible for our users.
The shadow it grows and takes the depth away.
So right here what we have are some assorted nuts, some dried fruits, some trail mix, etc. But then what you'll notice here is, what's in here? Why is it an opaque container? This is a crowd favorite, in this case, the infamous M&Ms. By limiting them or limiting the viewing access, it makes it easier for people to not get initially primed. Better choice here is buying in bulk product. It's gonna have less packaging and less waste, and allowing users to grab the portion that they want. You might notice that this cooler has a frosted glass at the very, very bottom. This is behavioral science in full effect. And if you think of what the industry does to promote specific products, we kind of flip this around. Googlers know that if they open up this, they're gonna find additional products that they may crave from time to time. So there's a variety of means and ways to obtain your hydration here. And for some individuals that are a little farther on the journey, they're probably gonna grab that glass and have that reused. But if you're hopping in your car onto a shuttle, you may be tempted to grab a bottle of water, which is perfectly acceptable as well.
Well, actually, the candy's hidden away. The soda's behind here, and the new Googlers or people will ask, well, why do they do that to you? We do this because we care. We want you to be at your best today, tomorrow, and the long term. They started to internalize this. Deeper down.